I got it for free yesterday, so I was like, fuck it, let's play some. Anyway, I don't know, we might like play some more of it. Probably play some more of it. I don't know. Caesar.
Yes.
Hi. Why are you so quiet?
Why am I so quiet?
I don't know. Let me turn you up. There you go. All right.
Oh yeah, it's turned me on. That's the best spot.
Did I actually close the game? No, I didn't. All right, fine. Looks fan made. Yeah, I don't know if I can really get into it. Like I can get into XCOM, to be honest. Maybe I will, maybe not. I've been considering going and playing some more like XCOM 2, like doing another playthrough of XCOM 2, if I can bring myself to do it. Because I really want to do a veteran, no, not veteran, commander? What's the hardest difficulty? Not the hardest, the second hardest.
Heard me plenty.
On Iron Man. Commander Iron Man playthrough. Sure. And, you know, it's a thing. Are we starting a new game or are we continuing? What do you want to
do? Do you want to start a new game?
Sure.
New stream, new game, new me.
Do you want to play on like... Do you want to play on normal like we did before? Hard survival, peaceful or creative?
I think we want a bigger challenge, don't we?
Sure. Do you want stronger enemies, tougher survival, or stronger enemies, rough survival?
What the fuck's the difference?
I don't know. I guess surviving's harder. There's probably like less food and stuff, maybe? I don't know.
That sounds like a pain in the ass. Yeah,
you probably just get hungry faster, I guess. I'll leave the players at like 4, I guess, and just invite you. I need to update the stream game. Invite friends, you... Get on board!
I'm in the board.
Get in board.
Oh, my squeaky chair is just so hot.
Did I tell you about my chair?
You don't need to tell me about your chair.
So when I put it together like 6 months ago, I put it around the wrong way?
Yeah, you told me that.
Oh man, my back. Oh, feels fucking good, man. Fucking, geez. Putting together like a ergonomically designed thing the wrong way makes it super non-ergonomic.
Gee, who would have seen that one coming?
Yeah. Moondoggy says, hey, Caesar.
Hello, Moondog.
You
Gee.
Cunt.
He said. Oh, okay. Well, that hurt my feelings.
You'll be fine. Are you sitting opposite me? Can you see me?
No, I can't. Are you inside me?
No, so I noticed when I was editing the other one, we actually were all sitting around the plane in different places.
On the right side?
I think it was Burrow was the guy next to the kid, and I was sitting like opposite. Moondoggy said, I didn't say that yet, but he does sound like a cunt. How do you tell that that's a red man?
He's red?
For me, he's like silhouetted. There's a light behind him, and all I can see is a black shape.
Well, it looks pretty red to me.
I don't know if I can't see anything or what. I just got an upskirt of the flight attendant as I stood up. My god, what is your skin?
You're like a black
Elvis. Look up. Look straight ahead. Oh my god, you're like an Indian Elvis. It's amazing. Oh god.
Of course your stream's frozen. What the hell's wrong?
Get
a better
get a better internet, he says as he lags out. That may be on my end, actually. It's possible. Is this going to be suitable? Still a little bit shitty, isn't it? Draw distance should be fine. Simple terrain, grass distance, medium grass density. I was going to turn some settings down so that I know that it's running fine and not having a fucking temper tantrum. Now, I'm not going to do what I did last time. Last time, I jumped straight off the plane. Turns out, actually, by the way, you can get back into the plane once you jump out. It's just a little bit fucking hard.
Build some stairs.
Yeah, that's probably an option as well. I didn't think of that. why is this so... I've got my settings on, like, the lowest settings, and I'm still dropping frames like a whore.
Whores drop frames, do they?
Apparently.
Yeah. You know how many whores that stream, do you?
Yeah, I do, actually. Coincidentally. So, let me grab all this goodness. Did you, stock up on your rice and veggies out of the plane?
Yes. If I didn't, there's no way I can get back in, how is there?
Well, I've been in the wilderness for like 2 minutes and I'm already at one with nature. There's a bird on my hand. And we are touching butts. Touching butts real bad.
I wish I had an ass.
Oh god, how bad is this gonna break stuff? So when you change resolution in this game, it doesn't let you change it and then hit apply. It just changes through the resolutions as you click through them. Seems like a super janky way to fucking do stuff, if you ask me, game devs, but, you know, fucking whatever. Is that better frame rate? Yeah, it is. Fucking way better. Okay, hang on. Let me drag this out and then we'll be Gucci.
What?
For some reason... If I stream in 2K, so like I'm streaming in 2K, I stream in 1080 and it downscales. So if I'm running the game in 2K, I get like 20 FPS. Feels good. All right, so we could turn this back up a little bit because this should be fine. What's happening? It's frozen. Hello? Caesar?
Mm.
Oh, okay. I thought I'd crashed. It's all right. Grass density, scatter light, sure. Is that better? It's way better.
Okay, is it?
Done. Settings sorted. Alright, what are we going to do?
I know, we're with the most hardcore place to build.
Fuck you, deer. Get that fucking deer. Against it. Most hardcore place to build. I don't know. I feel like, because you know how we found out like pretty late in our playthrough that like chopping down trees attracts more zombies or causes tougher zombies to
spawn. Pick up this meat.
Do you reckon we should try and do? Actually, hang on. What are the chiefs?
Just land clearing. We fucking near where we started, well, ended it last time.
Maybe.
Oh no.
So there's a vegan achievement, right?
I'd rather kill myself.
Play through the entire game without killing or... Oh, we've already broken it. Fuck. There's a guy here selling jousting sticks. Caesar, we should buy some jousting poles. And...
What?
Imagine that, a couple of paddock bombs, a couple of lances, and, you know, joust.
Well, yes, you're down here too now, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, I was looking at this squirrel down here. I thought it might have been a infamous badger.
Badger.
Yeah. Turns out, it's just a squirrel.
And life gives you badges, make squirrels.
It's lucky that, you know, it's lucky that being trapped in this situation, stuck on a on an island with no food or water, that I know how to perfectly skin and quarter a, like a various array of animals so that I can feed myself.
Isn't the backstory to this guy? He's like a survivalist fucking reality show guy, man.
No, I think he was just on TV because he survived. Are you referencing, like, the end?
No, I think there was, like, a book somewhere that was like, "Is it reality TV star Lost." No!
Ooh, are we, like,
Shark Infested Waters? I hope so.
Are we, like, Piss Drinker McGee?
Yeah. What's his Grill name? Bear.
Grill Bear, yeah. I did see a video the other day of somebody who'd built, like, on a cliffside like this, and he had an elevator, like a lift, that went all the way from the bottom to the top, which is pretty cool. But, yeah, anyway, I don't know. What do you want to build?
C4. It's pretty hardcore.
C4? You can't...
No, C4, you sunk my battleship.
Welcome, Fat Lordus. Yeah, what a name. What a fucking name. I really like those new alerts, actually. I forgot I'd been there.
Why has he got those annoying things that pop up in the middle of the stream?
Yeah, no, but...
You just had random screeching just
no,
as you
so
alert.
What I did is I took away my loud, obnoxious, like, alerts, and I replaced them with very low-key, subtle alerts. And it's really nice. It's really good. So there's no more Shrek going, "Why are you following me?" It's just a little bling and a little banner appears saying, "Welcome." It's good. It's good stuff.
I'm sorry I brought us this way.
10 out of 10. Yeah, why the fuck are we swimming around the fucking island, you cunt? Are you kidding? All I could see is cliffs.
I didn't think we'd go this far, to be honest.
I'm gonna fucking die of dehydration swimming. Oh man, the irony. I'm gonna die of dehydration in a large body of water. Anyway.
Let's build here.
Sure. This looks very similar to where we built last time.
Except last time we had beaches.
Yeah. So that video where I saw that guy building on the cliff, by the way, was a video which caught my attention because he was building an entire fence out of deadfall traps.
Reasonable.
So, yeah, so instead of, like, palisades, it was just a big old line of deadfall, which worked moderately well.
Yeah, wall traps worked moderately well as well.
Well, the problem was... Sorry, no, not the problem was. The benefit is that, A, the deadfall traps trigger and kill stuff, but B, they don't actually seem to attack traps. So if you put them close enough together that you can't get through them, then, you know...
You've got an impenetrable wall of spikes.
Yeah, apart from the mutants. The mutants will still wreck your shit. Because mutants OP, please enough. But yeah, no, it's
to be honest.
What see you up there?
I see a rabbit, a bush, and a rock.
Hey. I feel like I need to turn my settings back up a little bit. This game looks like melted chocolate.
Oh, I need to change my fucking hotkeys.
Oh yeah, that's the thing. Fun fact, okay, ready? We're gonna school some people right here. Cause I don't know about you, but we found it fucking infuriating that you couldn't set your hotkeys. Because right now, they're bound to fucking booze, soda, and meds. So you end up pressing 4 to get your axe out and you eat all your fucking meds. So if you combine your backpack and something, you can assign what fucking key to put it on. So, yeah, there you go. Set your hotkeys with your backpack. I mean, who wouldn't think of that, right? It's so intuitive. But, oh, shit.
Should we clear this area of forest?
I'll just do that. 1, 2, right.
I mean, it's
pretty much next to the biggest village in the game, and I'm sure they won't have any negative random effects.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's fine. Should we... Alright. Here's a challenge. We build in their base.
I mean, be a pain in the ass to get logs.
Yeah, I guess. Can we get a little four-legged whore?
Okay.
What the fuck? What did that hit? Just floating in midair. They're poisonous. Ow, goddammit. How fucking far away are you? This is like the last playthrough all over again. Look up and Caesar's just fucking 10 kilometers away. There's a lizard.
Oh yeah, I'm an explorer at heart.
There's a four-legged bishop.
Keep banging on that meme.
Yeah, I fucking love that scene. It's so good. It's kind of funny though, because... Well, it wasn't funny, but I wanted to use... Because I had so little of your perspective, I wanted to use it as much as possible. But I also didn't want to just use all of your footage because, like, from that video, because then it would have just been, like, a copy of your video.
Well, as long as you just, you know, put random shitty music over it, it's basically transformative work.
What? I don't think that's how YouTube works.
Yes. Yes, it does.
You can use anyone's content as long as you have music over the top of it.
Royalty-free music. You
into a lot of trouble.
It doesn't. It really doesn't. If it's what another YouTuber made, then no, not at all. If it's what
Surely
Sony Pictures made, then yes.
Surely you can't just,
Oh, hello.
Yeah, I just threw a tennis ball in it.
Surely... You what?
Ah! Whoa, all right, hey, why are you so angry? I just wanted to play a game, you whore! What is he doing? Race? Oh, I think I've been double teamed.
I'm about to die.
Yeah, I got hit once and it took like a third of my health, so it feels bad. I am now double teaming them. I'm penetrating one, and oh my god, yeah, they do a lot of damage.
Just remember this is your idea.
What, you wanted a challenge? Oh my god, there's a female.
I want a challenge, not to be fucking kicked. Oh god.
What's up, bitch? Come on! You wanna play fetch? Why is she so terrifying?
Because it's the opposite sex.
Okay, so we need armor, by the way. So first thing after we kill her is torch that lizard. Got it.
No, you don't.
There's another guy, like, walking towards us like a Terminator, by the way.
This explodes. No, it so does.
Oops. Alright, bam, I got one piece of armor. What are you doing up there? Fucking Tarzan! Get out of the tree!
My dad said I was special.
Alright, spear. No, why are they... Sure, let's build here. What could possibly go wrong, right? It's not like they're super aggressive.
They're what?
Get out of here! Jeez! I'm on fire. I'm gonna die to the fire. Don't die. Don't. I heard something. I think it was a bird. I'm gonna die here in a second, by the way.
Roy, you're on fire!
Is he attacking us?
Fuck. Isn't now.
Okay, I'm okay. I'm just okay. Let me get a clean spear. I don't know if that hit him or not.
Do better.
I missed, apparently. That phased through him. That one hit. There's more of them. Perfect. Is my food ready? Apparently, yes. Nom 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 nom.
What did I just eat?
I put food on the fire, so probably... What is up with my headset? I swear I can hear... Oh, there is more of them. Cool. What's up?
Yeah, there are.
What's up, boinks?
Zoink, Scoob.
He tried to eat the body. So did that one. Perfect.
Cool. Oi! Who did that?
Oh,
you're a... I had armor on.
Oh, I'm gonna die. I'm dead.
Me too. Oh, good.
I'm down.
Help. We shouldn't have burnt these men.
Karan Perkins here? Who is that? I don't know who that is.
Woo!
Does Caesar have the dukes required? Find out next time.
Not healing very fast.
No. Oh my god. Fucking fair plays. Cover me for a second while I look for the meds that I don't have in my backpack. Oh, so we're playing on hard, so I just realized what was going on. So I pressed to eat my meds, and it was taking a very long time to do. I hit him with a rock.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Oh my god, there's so many. This is the first night, and we're fucked. I'm down again.
Me too.
Feels good.
I am.
Wow, hard is a big step up from normal. Feels like we've gone from... Are you actually down?
Yeah.
Okay. Day survived, 0. Feels good. Maybe we...
Oh, he's hit my ass.
Maybe we need to hide.
Oh my god, I'm a black Elvis.
Maybe we need to hide more.
Should we, like, bump it down?
Do you want to go back to normal?
Or is this just our life now?
Where's your sense of adventure?
He just died in their camp. Get out of my way.
What the fuck? This is like being on a plane for realsies.
Get in the corner.
Oh my god. I mean, you can't sleep in here, so I really don't want to sit here, like, the whole night. But at the same time, I don't really want to get... Wait, where's my axe? Wait, do you not even get a starter axe when you respawn?
No, man.
Oh my god. Alright, should we try and sneak back into...
Yeah, sneak.
Camp. Fuck your face up. Do you want to swim the whole way again, or are you happy to actually run this time?
I feel like you're salty.
Alright, let's make a spear as well, because, you know, spears are a good time.
What?
Is this it here? Is this the one?
Oh, okay, this,
Flare's here. What the fuck? I guess I found somebody.
Man, they could at least left the bodies.
Oh, they all left. Yay!
Now, where were we?
Oh, you know, just making a fire so everyone can find us. Oh god, they're back already. Oh god, I'm down instantly. Like, instantly.
Oh yeah, we're on shit health.
Maybe we're not cut out for the hard life, Caesar.
Maybe not. Fuck. Run!
Run away!
Better have an accident.
Joker. I'm going down this hole. Bye.
There that goes.
Oh, well, fuck. I mean, I got away from the immediate threat. Oh, fuck!
Oh, you little tit. Oh, you bloody wank.
It scared the shit out of me. I thought that was a fucking...
The stream was a bad idea. Why did you make me do this?
What? Did you come down the hole?
No, I'm dead.
Uh-oh.
Oh, actually, I'm really dead. I got ejected.
Huh?
I got ejected from the game and I died so hard.
Really?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Oh, this is where you get the map and compass. Fucking instantly, what the hell? Could you join back? Or should we bump down the difficulty? How do I put this away?
Probably.
Alright,
just gonna say as I'm joining. Well, in the meantime, I uninstalled SCP Laboratories. That was fun.
You uninstalled it?
Yeah.
Why?
Well,
I thought you liked the meme fest.
I didn't like it. I was intrigued to know more. And I went around, learned the game properly. Yes, you know, so you don't know. You don't leave a game because you're shit at it. You leave it because it's actually terrible.
Yeah. Yeah, wow.
Game's alright. It's just the community.
I mean, the game's...
Like, main reason what made me uninstall it was, I was a Class D, and... You know how all the Class Ds just go to the machine room immediately and they all get fucking killed in a corner?
No.
Well, anyway, that's usually what happens, so I decided, oh, I'm gonna be smart this time. I'm just gonna wait near that hallway and just wait for everyone to get murdered and steal their stuff and just do it by myself. And anyway, I waited for them all to die, and just as I was about to leave, the I thought all the SCPs left to go to the service to go fuck with the security. Bloody, one of those SCPs shows up, looks at me, I'm like, there's no one here, and he just fucks off, and then I take a step forward and immediately get banned.
Huh? Get banned?
Yep, banned.
Why?
I'm gonna take a, I don't know, I'm gonna guess it's because I was quote-unquote holding up the game. Because apparently hiding, I don't know, I guess hiding so everyone else dies and you just, you know, you have a chance at actually winning is against the rules. I don't fucking know, it's stupid.
Sounds like me and TTT.
Yeah, exactly. It was exactly it. It was just they have their own stupid, dumb shit way to play the game, and you can't, you know.
Yeah, exactly. You can have the best intentions in the world and know what you're doing, but in the end, if you're an outsider or if you're a newcomer, fuck you. It feels bad.
Yeah, it's a community run by 12-year-olds, so there's that too.
If only Gmod was a bit easier to run a server of, it'd be fine. But no, apparently it's...
You know, why would you want to run that? Why would you want to fucking administer that?
Not for public, for us.
Right.
But, you know... Apparently you need to have a fucking... Where'd that deer go? No, over there. Apparently you have to have, like, a fucking degree in scripting to be able to fucking manage a gaming server. Fucking get round! I just fucking headshot a deer with a spear. 10 meters. Feels fucking...
Achievement for it?
No, I didn't, actually.
That sucks.
If you could refund. Me achieve... like, you know, outside of the game, that'd be great.
Yeah, sure, I'll give you a free blowjob.
Yay! Just what I always wanted, a toothy blowjob.
Mouth job, what is it?
Mouth job, yeah. Speaking of mouth jobs,
It's okay, I'm not missing some of my front teeth.
I don't know where I was going with that. Anyway, look, I've got some deer meat, you've got some wood, let's make lots of money. There's another deer. Fucking, oh god, I'm on fire with this spear tonight. Ooh. Two from two on the deer front, by the way. Just want to put that out there.
I have a tennis ball.
Don't fucking tennis ball me, you whore.
There's another deer over there, go get it.
Where? Oh, over there, ready? Yeah! Bam, three from three.
You
can't touch this. I can't carry any more meat. Come and get this meat. Come and put my meat in your mouth. Oh, hey. Why are you Indian Elvis again?
Because I am a enthusiast of the Elvis.
Feathers.
Oh, thank hell, let's not go that way. Why? Actually, no, let us go that way, because it's like early in the day.
I'm collecting... Feathers. Where are you going?
Every. Again.
Oh, yeah, good. Yeah, because, you know, nothing bad happened here last time. Come here, you whore! Shit.
Only have enough meat.
Yeah, fucking.
Don't even have a drying rack.
Oodles and noodles. see you, lizard boy.
Yar, I'm Davy Blarins.
He's running away like a little bitch. So. Why isn't this working? Oh, because I've still got a feather there. That's why.
Birds of a feather make a giant leather cat.
What?
You're trying to visualize that, weren't you?
Look.
Big old leather kitty.
Talking about furries again?
Furries are furry, not leathery.
I mean, I guess it depends on what your fursona is, right? What's your fursona, Caesar?
I don't even know what that word means.
Where's slip space when you need it?
You have to be more kind of your millennial shit.
Your fursona is like your furry animal. Like, what you dress up as.
Oh.
Where's that little cave?
What the hell? I just went flying.
The map's just down here. Do you want to come and grab the map real quick?
Yeah, I'm just going to grab Blaster's cloth.
Well, why? Look, there's Laffy boys down here. Hello? Yeah, there's one up here. Scare me this time. I was ready for you. That's right.
Oh, geez, they're just coming at me.
Oh, they're up there, are they? Okay, bam.
Okay, let's, oh, dear. Oh, there are a lot of them. Oh boy, right, don't come up here.
Compass. Alright. Do you want to do like...
Actually, no. Stay down there, in fact. And hope they can't climb.
Do you want to do like an early cave? Early cave run?
I'm coming down now, because there is no hope up there. The fuck? Oh, you hit him when money falls out.
Yeah, he's like a pinata.
Yeah, like in real life.
Like a money pinata. Yeah, do you know if you hit people in real life, money falls out of them? Yeah, there you go. There's
just explicitly, that's how I fucking make my living.
r/TIL. Yeah, Caesar just walks around punching people and money falls out.
It's great.
What have we got down here? There's a little hole. There's another little rope boy going down further. Sure. Ooh. It's a very short rope. Comes out. Hello? He tried to jump me! Oh, he did jump me! Yeah, you take much less damage on that. That is such a ridiculous step up from normal to hard. Like, oh my god, please help. Oh my god, he's kicking my fucking ass, by the way, just to let you know.
I'm coming.
Oh, he's fucking Neo as well, apparently. What the fuck? You little dodge! Ugh! Boy. Oh, right, I fucking got it. Sort of.
It's okay, I'm here now.
Okay, now he's dead. Fucking hell, that guy. What a jerk. Let me take his teeth. Also, where'd my other arrows go? So I really don't have enough to be wasted.
Bats!
Yeah, can you actually fucking...
Shit. Damn.
Can't do anything. Can't harvest their leathery wings for...
Pleather.
For pleather, yeah. Ready? Did I just eat my meds? I did. Here's Johnny! And here's Mick.
How do you know my name?
I recognized you from your fursona.
My fursona's named Barry.
What?
Stop stabbing the fucking bats.
Job I was at today, right?
You have a job?
Hello? Somebody join the Discord?
No.
I thought I heard Slipspace try to say something about fursonas and then get out of. Yeah, surprise, surprise, I actually have a job. Because believe it or not, Twitch streaming is not my primary source of income. I don't do this day in, day out. Feels bad. Anyway, what was I even saying? Oh yeah, so I was working in this bedroom, right? So there was a roof leak, water damage, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, so I'm plastering away. And it was the most uncomfortable day of work because there was a massive poster of Justin Bieber on the wall. And there was other various things, like a few, like, One Direction posters and, like, that sort of stuff. Like, a very teenage girly type room.
It was, like, a 40-year-old man.
Well, I was like, okay, sure, it's probably, like, you know,
maybe... We shouldn't be here.
What, like, 15, 16? Probably not even that. Maybe, like, 13 to 15, I guess? And I was like, okay, fine, whatever. Sure, people are into Justin Bieber and fucking stuff. I get it. No, it turns out she's 17.
That's not that bad.
Well, I mean, I don't know much about, like, you know, what 17-year-old girls are into, but I feel like if you're 17, you've still got posters of One Direction and Justin Bieber on your wall.
Okay, time to go.
Duh. Cover me while I light an arrow.
Really? We're gonna fight this thing?
Yeah. Why not? Use Lottoman. Lottoman. Sure.
Well, you can. I'll just stand here. No, you're gonna fight it. Oh, get past me.
I'm collecting my arrows. I've only got a few. I'm gonna die. How am I not dead? Oh my god, what?
I've defeated the beast.
What? See? I told you we could do it. Didn't even panic.
Immediately to fucking creepy skin armor.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Hey, dudes.
Oh, hey. Oh,
okay. Thought someone was much worse.
Thought it was Sip's face.
Yeah.
Everyone run!
Ow, fuck off.
Shift, you're live on the interwebs.
Ah.
FYI.
Hey, Twitch, subscribe!
Nice. You're a regular Twitch streamer. My lighter keeps going out. What the shit?
Because you got it from Safeways.
Yeah, it's like a... It is actually like a Bic lighter. Have you noticed? It's got like a
I'm sorry, I don't believe in that political agenda.
What the fuck? Fuck you. I can't remember what I was talking about. I got slightly distracted by this recording all of the luggage. Why can I not... Hello? Jeez.
Could you not be horrible?
I just ate my meds again. Fuck this game. Auto-binding shit. Alright, let's... I've got one med left. Let's find not fucking... What, a stick?
Oh, sure. Meds up here.
I just have to take my meds off my fucking hot bar so that I stop... accidentally eating them. And a cassette and fuel. Sure. Alright. Onwards through the cave or back?
Can we even go anywhere in this cave?
Yeah. You can go anywhere through any cave. Right. There's a rope here. Where does this go? Does this go out?
Well, I hope so.
Alright, fuck it. Go this way. Oh yeah, it does. I can see daylight. I see fields of green.
Don't look down, by the way.
Roses too. What?
We don't find that all creepy.
What?
I'm inside you.
Oh. I missed what you said. That's why I didn't find it creepy. Have you ever considered
Yep. Every night.
That. You know, Elon Musk said life is a simulation.
And like, what?
Elon Musk
said... That guy's on fucking pills, man.
That we're, like, in the Matrix.
I'm pretty sure people said that before him or whatever.
Yeah, I know. But that's the thing. Like, this is Elon Musk, though. This is poster boy.
It's You're not I don't aware know of his insanity?
I don't know if he said that. I think he said it could be.
Yeah, he said that there's a very high possibility that we are living in a simulation.
Mm.
How did I miss that bird? Oh my god.
I got it.
Triggered. You gotta spend feathers to get feathers, right?
Or you just whack off an axe, one of the two.
Fuck you and your axe, Gimli. Cunt. I will take Legolas's bow, please. In other news,
I've become a Thetan.
Edible berries, right here.
Why would I want to eat berries?
Oh, you know, to keep your hunger up, so you got energy to get through your day.
Keep my hunger up, eh?
Yeah. That's right.
You and what army?
Because, you know, berries are low in carbs, which means you can eat a lot of them without feeling full. Citation needed. Alright, my hunger and my thirst is zero.
Why?
Because I just ate a heap of berries. See what I did there? Hunger and thirst is zero because I filled them up.
I get it, it's a sex thing.
Yeah, you fucking know it. Mind over matter in the building. What the hell? Come on. You little fluffy tailed fuck! Come here! Oh, this is just like real life. Gotcha. What's everyone been doing? I've been away for like days.
I've been away for 2 days.
Three.
Oh no.
Is everyone touching some butts?
I'm fucking that crone up, that witch bitch in Warhammer.
Worry with us, and just gotta go for a second.
We should play some Warhammer.
Dude, so feel the same thing happened to me. That fucking those Illyrian cunts stole the Sword of Cain.
Oh yeah.
Fucking so filthy. I would have had it if I lost my first battle I ever lost in Warhammer. I was so pissed.
What? You lost no the idea. First battle you've ever lost in Warhammer?
Yeah, I was so
what?
Been annoyed.
How is that the first battle you've lost in Warhammer?
I mean, I'm just a fucking child prodigy, bro.
You're either insanely good or a quicksaver.
Yeah, of course. You think I am?
I mean, yeah, sure.
As soon as it looks like I'm losing,
just reload. Bam, quick load. Fuck it, I'm out. I lost my unit, I'm out.
One person dies.
Yeah. If it's not 100% survival rate, I'm fucking out. I'm done.
Hey, we're back here.
The outer walls are breached. Into the keep.
I have fucking... You know that scene in Return of the King where the armored troll comes through the gate and just like smashes like 10 guys out of the way?
Yeah.
So I was playing as the High Elves in Total War, and I had a scene where I was fighting Chaos, and I had this like row of archers stood behind the wall firing like out, and they had this troll, and their like artillery was firing at a wall segment, and the wall segment came down, and their giant immediately walked through and just went ham on these archers. And I zoomed right in, I watched it all happen in like cinematic cam, and it was just like that scene. This massive guy, massive armored guy, comes through the wall and just swings and just cleans up like 15 archers.
All I can think about that is fucking Sean Bean. They have a cave troll.
They have a cave troll. Yeah. There's a couple of screenshots of it on my Steam, if you have a look. But yeah, it was pretty crazy. It's one of my most memorable Total War moments.
I like how Illyrian, whatever the fucking name is, has treekin and dryads and like the tree giants.
Yeah.
I fucking can't wait for a fucking tree giant. I'm gonna fucking ruin cunts with that bitch.
Have you
I'm gonna
played,
march it straight out the middle.
Have you played the Wood Elves?
Yeah. I fucking hated that because they're so boring. Because you can't. Because they have all the buffs for forest. As soon as you go outside of your area, you're fucked because there's no forest.
It's very hard. Yeah,
it's such a niche element of your unit, and you just can't use any of it.
Yeah,
I liked ambushing that. Ambushing with Wood Elves is so much fun. I enjoyed that.
There is a mod which lets the elves spread. So you know how like dark elves spread corruption? Basically, wood elves can spread like magical forest, essentially.
Yeah, okay.
I did a wood elf campaign, and it was a really, really tough slog. Like, it's fucking ball breaking.
Yeah. So right now, old Manny with the sword of Cain, I'm encircled this town and the Shrine of Cain, and old Manny with the sword who's on my side is like come up right next to me, and I'm not sure whether I should turn on him and attack him but he's got like a full stack, so I don't know.
Yeah.
So I'm scared. Why am I injured? When did that happen? Oh, that's the other thing, man. So I encircled this town, right? And then he came out and attacked me while I was encircling him, right?
Yeah. And it was an
enemy. I defeated him. I just slaughtered him, right? Yeah. And then I still don't take the town. And they just automatically gets all their units back.
Yeah.
I'm just like, what the fuck? How is that fair? I literally just demolished the garrison,
super garrison.
They just instantly straight back to where they were again. I was like, what the fuck?
The thing that annoys me, which happens quite often, is the garrison will like sully forth. Like they'll like without an army there. So normally, like you can't, if somebody's encircling your town, you can't go out and fight them unless you have an army there or like a hero to lead them, right?
Yeah.
The AI, though, doesn't apply. So their garrison will just fucking march out and fire. And you're just like, what the fuck?
Yeah. I don't really want to play this game because there's so many.
Yeah, it's a very like AI heavy.
Piss me off.
Yeah. I love the way you built a thing and then didn't sleep. Are you going to sleep? Or are you
I'm going to eat this thing just real quick.
Oh, fuck it. I'll feed you something real quick. Don't you worry. Open your mouth.
Why do you like this?
Because I'm wearing a Hat Films jumper.
Who the fuck is Hat Films?
I got breakfast. Meat's back on the menu, boys.
Is it semen?
No, it's squirrel. What do you think? I just said I got a squirrel. Meat's back on the menu. What do you think it's going to be? A fucking elephant?
Squirrel semen?
Open your fucking mind. Crow. 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 Gotcha.
You gonna get the crow?
Oh, eventually. If I try hard enough. Apparently my arms are like 6 foot long to grab that feather out of the sky. But you know what? I'm kind of okay with that. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Five, my six, arms seven, are like nine, that. And it's really unsettling.
11. I was one of them. I have so much meat, by the way. I literally have like 14 pieces of meat in my inventory. Can we... Oh, what the fuck?
Oh, wow. I apologize.
Yeah. Fuck you. Can I have that? Look, don't worry about it.
Good job.
Do you need some food?
No, I have plenty of meat.
Well, look. an extra meat per day keeps the doctor away. And by doctor, I mean cannibal. Where'd my spear go, by the way? It sort of went through.
Be right back.
I don't think you'll be back.
Not far from last time. I'm back already, cunt.
You know what I need to get? Which I don't know if you can for Streamlabs OBS, but I want the like Discord overlay thing that shows you who's fucking speaking and in the channel.
It turned up once and never appeared again, so I don't know how to get it back.
Sounds like a hooker.
Oh, are you talking about Overwolf or?
No, not Overwolf, it's TeamSpeak. Yeah. You idiot.
Don't. Stop hitting me. Yeah, no, I was using like an add-on for OBS, but now I've swapped to Streamlabs OBS, and I don't know if the same thing works. Fucking. Burn! Man, it's really got a tight grip. Really got a tight grip on there. Alright, what are we doing? What's today's plan?
Find a place to build our society.
Okie day. Roger, roger. So the new campaign writing is going well.
I don't know, why don't you set one actually in a historical city?
Because
think about it.
Fuck me in the ass, Caesar, because people will be like, actually, if you look at the historical documents from 1642, you'll see that they actually didn't have that technology, and you're doing it wrong. Yes. If it's my world, I can be like, fuck you! That's right! They have fucking telephones because, I don't know, fucking Jack LaMardia fucking made them up. Alright? I can make my own rules.
I found a place to build. Come over here.
Hang on, I'm chasing a lizard trying to work out how to pull a fucking normal arrow out. Yeah, no, I don't want to do anything realistic because that gets people riled up, apparently. And I don't want to deal with people.
Think you're a coward.
Yeah? Well, I don't care what you think, so who's the bigger man? Ye who throws stones or ye who takes it like a man? What? We're back where we fucking were last time!
I know, it's a great spot, isn't it?
Oh, fuck me! Stop! You're the worst. I kind of want to build out on the White Tree of Gondor, to be honest.
Let's not.
What?
I'm not gathering all those fucking logs.
Can we just cave dive until we get a better axe or a chainsaw? Because fuck me, I do not want to spend like 4 hours cutting wood.
Well, off you go.
Alright, I'm just going to look up where the chainsaw is, because I like, fuck, you know, at all. Chainsaw. Official The Forest Wiki. The chainsaw is in your ass. That's right.
It only spawns when you kill a certain number of enemies.
What? That's not right.
But I had you going, didn't I?
Look, alright, don't tempt me. Where's cave 3?
I don't know, they're not numbered.
It's the wet cave. And one near the dirty white tents across from two cannibal structures nearby. I mean, how does that help?
Well, oh, that is...
Yeah. I know where it is. Follow me.
Oh, did you know that if you own the shrine of the Widowmaker, you can get the Sword of Cain?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I thought you just had to fucking run around and kill everybody.
No, you have to own that. You have to have that city.
Oh, that's why that cunt's up here.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying.
Like, yeah, I killed... So the people that controlled that city, I killed all of them, and then all I had to do was walk in and defeat the garrison, and the other elves walk in there and took it from me. So then I had to fight them as well.
Still quiz.
Yeah, it wasn't Illyrian. It was the other one, like to the west, on that outer ring, like past the Phoenix Gate, I think.
Okay.
Fucking high elves. Ugh.
Ugh. Incredibly.
Fucking jerks.
Sick.
So I found something out the other day while I was trawling through Star Reddit. Wars related content.
You gonna tell me about the fucking how the Emperor's really the hero again?
No. Oh, I hate the Emperor. Fuck the Emperor. Down with the Emperor. No, what I was going to say is, you know the YouTube channel Star Wars Theory?
Yeah.
So, he put out a video the other day.
You said that with such reluctance.
I wasn't...
Anyways, yeah. Like, yes.
Yeah, so we put out a video the other day about the Solo movie, right? And said, look, the all movie? In all, it's not very good, blah, blah, blah. You know, what fucking everybody's been saying about it. Anyway... He went on, and the part that I got a little bit excited, because he's like, apparently whoever made the movie, like the producers or the writers or director, I don't know, somebody was like tweeting in response to like all the stuff, and he was like, okay, so they're listening to what people want, right?
Well, yeah, but they're not going to hide again, are they?
So, well, the whole thing was that the Solo movie was crowdfunded, right? And they were like, okay, well, if they're listening to people, let's give them some suggestions. This is a channel with, like, however many subs he's got, like, fucking 1.5 or something. And...
He got 1.5 subs, does he?
Yeah, yeah. So he's like, look, here's some suggestions. And I got excited, because I'm like, this guy knows his stuff. Like, big Star Wars fan. I hope he's got, like, some good suggestions. And he just went on to ramble off, like, he's like, you could... make a trilogy about Obi-Wan. You could make a trilogy about fucking... Like, he just basically listed every Jedi that is not a main character. Like, Mundi and fucking... like, the three that died in the throne room. But the thing was, he didn't just suggest, like, oh, it'd be cool to have, like, an Obi-Wan backstory movie. He's like, no, you could make a trilogy about some... Jedi that was mentioned once in a comic book somewhere, and I'm like, well, okay, sure, that's probably better than a Han Solo movie, but it's completely unrealistic to think that that's ever going to get made. Like, if you said a single movie, because he didn't once suggest a single movie, everything he suggested was a trilogy, which is absurd. But you know, if you said, oh, it'd be cool to have a movie expanding on like Anakin during the Clone Wars, because there's a lot that happens between like episode 2 when the Clone Wars start and episode 3 when he turns to the dark side. Like there's a huge time period there where Anakin does a lot of good and he becomes like a huge part of the Clone Wars and like becomes a pinup essentially for like the Jedi, like the academy and that, or like the people aspiring to be Jedis. So anyway, that'd be cool. I'd like to see an Obi-Wan movie, but what I would really like to see is a movie based around some of the particular like clone regiments, because like some of the canon, oh sorry, it's not canon anymore, so some of the legends stories for like the clone, like the 501st, or I mean the 501st would probably be the most interesting because they have the most stuff written about them, I guess, but there's a lot of cool stories for the other guys as well. Like, I don't know if you know, but like a few of the clone troopers find out that they have the chip that makes them comply with like Order 66 and that, and they set about like removing it, and they survive like the Clone Wars. They like they abandon the military and, like, yeah, survive.
Did they write a book about it?
It's covered in
not
the Clone Wars, like the TV series.
The clones, they write a book about it.
Oh, fuck. Okay. Anyway.
Why do I end up back here?
So, anyway, getting back to the whole reason I brought this up, is he's like, I don't think it was actually that video, it was like the next video afterwards, because he's like, I'd like to see a Darth Vader movie, but I'm already working on that, and I just didn't pay much attention to it. Next video comes out, and it's like just him, and he's going, look guys, we've got like 3 days left on the Kickstarter, you know, there's 1.5 million subs here, or whatever he's got. If we all just donate $1, that's easily enough to get this funded, blah, blah, blah. Like as if every single subscription is an active viewer of the movie. So this is, like, I think, you know, like, his channel might get, like, 40,000 views on a video or something. So sure, you might have 1.5 million subscribers, but it's the views that really matter. But anyway, it turns out this Kickstarter that he started to fund a Darth Vader movie is for $1 million.
Only a million.
Yeah, only a million. And the time period to fund it was 1 month. And he's like, yeah, look, guys, it's looking like it's not going to happen. No fucking shit! You said to raise $1 million in a month, advertising it nowhere but your YouTube channel, which gets 40,000 views per video. Like, how does somebody think that that's going to work? On the other hand, so on top of the fact that the math doesn't matter, like, nobody who actually, like, sure, people might go, yeah, I'll put $5 in, or whatever, or somebody might be like, oh, this is a fucking brilliant idea, I'm going to put $1,000 in. But anybody who has an actual idea is going to be like, why would I give some YouTuber money to make a film? Somebody who doesn't know anything about filmmaking, somebody who probably has no contacts in the film industry, like, I don't understand. I mean, good on him for, like, wanting to get it done, but, like, does he have a plan past the Kickstarter?
Like, no, that's easy.
I mean, making a fucking a proper film requires more than some shitty editing skills and a YouTube channel. Like, I don't know. The whole thing, a little bit of a fucking, you know, thing. There's no chainsaw in here. I've just been walking around in a circle for like 10 minutes while I rant. But yeah.
And what are, this tree just ate my spear.
But yeah, so Star Wars Darth Vader movie. I don't think it's Darth happening because the Kickstarter's probably finished by now. And it would have failed, so. Feels good.
Dude, how do I get this fucking sword?
I think you have to control the city. But then I don't know because I never got this far, but I'm pretty sure you have to control the city, and then if somebody already has it, you have to take it from them. I think. But I'd capture the city first in case it does just take it off them and give it to you.
Yeah, I already captured the city. I just fucking...
Ah, okay.
Salarian cunt is running back to his fucking asshole of a town. I'm gonna go fuck him in it. Because I thought I wasn't getting the sword because Alaria's got a stave already. So I was like, oh, okay. Actually, I haven't even checked if I can equip it. No. Can't. So I went and bought another hero who has a sword, and lo and behold, he cannot equip the sword either.
I don't know entirely how it works. Like I say, I never got to the point where I had the sword. I do intend to play some more of that. But I haven't got there. Turtle. Don't glitch out.
There is a new one turtle. that you should be worrying about.
Your turtle?
My turtle.
Oh, God. Don't turtle me, bro.
Yeah, but I don't like the, bloody Star Wars theory people. Like, all the other ones, Stupendous Wave, I think.
Yes,
well, number one, because they're all just wild theories and just speculation. Yeah. There's not really much analysis. And also, they fucking spoil everything when it comes out, immediately.
That was the other thing. I watched
it. They're kind of like Dark Souls fucking theorists. They just make wild speculations that have no bearing on fucking reality.
Yeah, so, like, I kind of like watching them occasionally. I don't watch many of them, but I watch, like, the odd one from, like, Star Wars theory just when I, like, want to know something in particular, because they tend to have a video on pretty much everything. So I was watching one, and he's like, oh, what would have happened if, oh, that's right, it was the Darth Vader one. So apparently, like, Darth Vader was offered, like, a better suit or something, right? Because his suit was designed to be, like, restricting your movement and stuff so that he could never overthrow Palpatine. Or Darth Sidious.
No, Darth Palpatine, you got it right the first time.
So, the video was, like, what if Vader had have got the better suit? What if he had have got the advanced suit, which let him be faster, more agile, etc., etc.? And the first half of the video, really good, and he's like, oh, you know, it means he would have had full use of his arms, he would have been able to do this, he probably would have won the fight against Luke in whatever episode it was, blah, 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 blah. The second half of the video is him just going, so, yeah, he probably would have won the fight against Luke, which would have forced Luke into a corner and Sidious would have given him the option to join or die, but then Vader, realizing that he was more powerful than the Emperor, would have fought the Emperor with Luke at his side, they would have won, they would have returned to Naboo and fought the Empire as father and son. I'm like, wait, whoa. You're saying that just at the flick of a switch, Vader just would have been like, yeah, you know what? Fuck it, let's kill the Emperor and just go fight for the rebels. Just like at the drop of a hat, just because he got a better suit. I don't think so, son. What the fuck? So, like, yeah, a lot of it's still just speculation bullshit, really. But, oh, all my meat has spoiled into the abyss.
Don't worry, I have some food back at the shelter.
Well, I had to jump down a cave to get the chainsaw, so I'm slowly trying to work my way out now.
Well, good luck with that.
Yeah, the problem is that there is people in front of me. I do, however, have the chainsaw, and I just made some stealth armor, so down in the bottom of this cave, which is surrounded by stone and water, I'm covered in leaves, which apparently makes me harder to see. Excuse moi. How do I get out? How do I get out of here? I'm going to assume there's a way out somewhere. I don't have any flares. I'm vastly ill-prepared for this operation. I think I can do it, though. By God, I think I can do it. Alright. You, me, and Dupree. Let's fucking... also, another thing I found related to movies. I was browsing through Reddit and I saw a thing on r/movies saying that Zombieland 2 is due for release, like, in the next couple of months. Which apparently nobody knew was even getting filmed. So, is it a troll? Or is there actually...
I mean, it's a film, not a troll.
Or is there actually a Zombieland 2 coming out? Stealthing OP, by the way. Where did that arrow go? I can't see what I'm aiming at. Found some bullets. That's what we have to do. Okay, we have to get a gun. Remember last time we never got a gun? Oh, I want a gun.
Yeah. I thought it was going to be wildly overwhelming. Or underwhelming.
I mean, yeah, probably, but it's a gun.
We've never seen one of those before.
Yeah, I know. Kieran Perkins.
I don't think he's even still here.
Kieran Perkins. I just realized what he might have been talking about. Getting back to D&D, have I told you there's going to be like... Oh my god, there's so many mutants around me and I'm just like stealthing through the shadows like a fucking ninja. I'm kind of terrified though, by the way. You can't see me because I'm crouched. Shit.
Oh.
I just have no idea where I am and I don't know where the exit is and I'm scared. I'm a scared little boy. Lost in a cave.
Don't try and turn shift on, it won't work.
And Lord Derpington is playing totally accurate battle simulator.
You know him?
Yes.
Jesus Christ. How the fuck do you know Reese?
For you, fucking lunatic.
I didn't think I had talked to him since, like, I was 16 or something.
He's been on my friends list forever. Like, it's not like we have a talk. He's just on my friends list. Cause...
Mm.
I'm with a bunch of random people.
Should get newer friends.
Yeah. I've been thinking about it, but I've actually got like 7 or more fucking friend requests pending. I'm just like, eh.
They stream sycophants or people that just want your dick?
A little bit of both. But, yeah, fuck off. I don't know. Apparently my axe is on my hotkey. It's on 3. Why can I... Oh, there we go. Okay, I can dynamite through here. The problem is I don't have any dynamite. Somebody give me some dynamite!
I have some dynamite.
Ugh, there's fucking babies down here everywhere.
Yeah, when grows will be like that.
Kind of annoying. Baby.
I was sitting in the car park the other day.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, no worries, right? I was in the car park the other day, and I noticed, like, everyone in this fucking town has, like, a long car, like, a family car.
There's another one! Stay in the water so I can silhouette you. Oh, bam. Now I can see where he is based on my arrow. He's still up. Oh, I'm fighting in the dark with a ranged weapon.
Seems like your disadvantage.
Oh. Where are you? Oh, that was a bad miss. Oh, fuck. I am, like, honestly... Call me fucking Darkman Bishop, because Dark Diver Bishop.
Yeah, I was gonna say, where the fuck's that going?
Dark Diver Bishop. It's a there we go. Bam, Dark Souls reference. Get it in.
Dark Diver?
Isn't it? Or Dark Lurker? Is it?
Oh, Dark. Yeah, Dark Lurker.
Dark Lurker. Call me Dark Lurker Bishop. Because I am.
Okay, Edge Lord Bishop.
Edge Lord Bishop. I fucking do not know how to get out of this cave. Send help, please. I'm gonna die down
here. I would, but I'm setting up the upholstery.
I think I found it. I think I found the way. I think I have found the way.
Get a turtle while you're at it.
I've got a turtle.
Cool.
I found a slither... a slither rock.
What?
I found a slither rock.
You mean Harry? Just Harry? You mean Harry?
You're a wizard, Harry.
You're a rapist, Harry.
What?
A rapist?
You can't say that. It's 2018.
I'm sorry.
Doesn't make sense.
Raper.
You ever been raped?
It's like the first question that an anime lord asks his new date.
What a statement.
Oh,
fucking they exchange pleasantries.
It's like a super awkward, like yeah. You just don't know what to say and you just open your mouth and that comes out.
Raped?
Just an anime lord just like exchanging pleasantries with his new date. Instant silence after that.
Yeah. Just gets up and silently walks away, just like not a word spoken. Just like,
I like dogs. Trying to think of something to impress her. I like dog fighting.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah. So, have you ever been to a dog fight?
Oh man, too good.
Isn't that a thing in, so I'm hoping to get Tim to play Super Seducer. I'm pretty sure that's a thing in it. She's like, one of the dialogues goes like, she's like, oh, I'm really into dogs. And he's like, oh yeah, me too. And she's like, oh really? And he's like, yeah, yeah, I go and watch dog fighting all the time. Oh, I really like it. And she's like, dog fighting. He's like, yeah, you know, when the big dog just and like tears up the little dog. Oh, that's really good. That guy, fucking hilarious. What a fucking lad. What a fucking lad.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, no, so I'm hoping, like, maybe Tim and I at some point just for the lols.
I hope you learn something.
Run.
Oh, fuck! Some dude just fucking captured the Sword of Cain, and I'm fucking allies with him. I just declared war against that cunt, and now they've claimed it. For fuck's sake.
Fuck me.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, I'm hoping this is a rope out. I'm pretty sure it is, if I remember correctly. I just got jumped by an armsy and like 10 guys, by the way. I just fucking legged it. I just speed ran the shit out of it.
Nice.
Nice. Remember Driver 2? Do you ever play Driver 2?
I don't play racing games.
That wasn't really a racing game.
Really?
Yeah. So Driver 2 was the only Driver game. Or was it Driver 3? No, it was Driver 3, sorry. The only Driver game where you could like I think I'm mixing up my drivers here. Anyway, I think Driver 2 you could get out of the car. Driver 3 was set in Nice. Or one of the places was Nice. I'm confused now. Anyway, what I was going to say is one of the Driver games had a setting in Nice. And do you know how confusing that was for like a young boy who didn't really understand that Nice can be pronounced as Nice and it can be the name of somewhere. I thought just the map was called Nice because it was a nice looking map.
But as the incultured swine that you were wrongly assumed.
Like, leave me alone. Sorry, I wasn't fucking cultured with worldwide locations at the age of 10. Jerk.
You play more Crusader Kings by the age of 10.
Yeah. Can you imagine? Were you playing Crusader? I was about to say people that played Crusader Kings at 10 are probably the worst kind of people, but I feel like I should ask you if you played Crusader Kings at the age of 10 before I say that.
I know, I play, Jack actually introduced me to it. When he introduced me to it, he was like, so it's like this pen and paper game, and I'm like, don't give a shit. And I just didn't say anything for like a month, and one time I was just sitting in TeamSpeak, listening to him play, and I was like, what the fuck is this shit? And so I bought it and opened it up, and I was like, ah, fuck, what is this? And I just opened it up, all I saw was just the GUI, and next minute I know, I was like fucking 4 in the morning, and well, fast forward to now, it's like 2,000 hours later, nearly.
Yeah. Oh, how you feel.
I see you over there, I'm looking directly at you. And I beat him with that arrow back. Welcome to our new home.
What the fuck is this?
What? Oh, thank... Oh, now the fucking rain stopped. God damn it.
Well, look, what do you want?
Run faster.
Okay, you know what food? I got, though.
Chainsaw. Well, in the morning, we can start the deforestation project and build a strip mall.
Strip mall!
Oh. Just go to sleep with the chainsaw on.
Yeah.
I needed to make me fall asleep. Well, off you go. Should we build some tree houses?
No, let's build like a log cabin.
Don't get that.
The game audio is incredibly loud.
No one will stop watching the stream because of it.
Graphics, gameplay, where's volume? Ah, audio.
That didn't work.
Is that better? It's probably better. Better run through the jungle. I was gonna get some dynamite, but I got jumped right where the dynamite is. So I figured a chainsaw would have to do.
Should we build a custom building? Yeah.
Sure. Let's build just a big ass building that can have everything inside of it. So we just never have to leave. It can be like real life. We can stay inside the whole weekend. I want power, I want 100 gigabit a second download speed. I want insulated walls with soundproof foam so I don't have to hear the mutants outside.
I'm just gonna get attacked by like a fucking battalion in the morning.
Make it happen!
Daddy!
Can you imagine the mess if this is how, like, you actually felt? Like, you just went into an area and just cut down every tree and then you were like, alright, time to clean it up!
Well, you say that, but, I didn't work for a, tree feller for...
Well, yeah.
Breaking shit.
Like, I should, yeah, I mean, so obviously, like, people do that to a degree. I think if you have the machinery to deal with that, it's okay. But I'm talking, like, small scale. Like, two guys with a chainsaw. Can you imagine, like, the heads? Like, just how many heads of trees it would be that you would have to fucking clean up? It would be...
Yeah, took a week.
It takes, like, half a day to clean up one tree.
Oh, that didn't work out there.
Better run through the jungle. You heard of Vero, Caesar?
Nope.
Social networking platform. Came out a little while ago. It's basically
did it crash and burn, like, Braille?
Sorry?
Has it failed spectacularly?
Well... So the idea behind Vero was it was meant to be a combination of like Twitter, Instagram, and Pinterest, right? So are you familiar with those three platforms?
Yes.
Okay, so basically Vero was meant to combine all three in one nifty little package so that it would be great. So I was on it. I was like, fuck it, I'll set up a thing. If it takes off, I've got an account. Bam. So I logged into my Vero the other day. It is full to the brim.
Sex box.
With, like, cam showgirls.
Literally.
Yeah, like, that's all that's on there. So, like, I follow, like, a few people on there. And, like, you know, like, content creators, like, YouTubers, streamers. I follow, like, a few, like, just big Instagrammers from, like, I know of Instagram and that, because they were, like, promoing it when Vero started up. But basically, nothing has been posted by them since, like, the release of Vero. And I've been followed by, like, 50 people that just immediately message you and they've, like, hey, come and check out my cam show. Don't give anyone this link because it's for Vero users only. And just, like, a link and, like, pay $50 here. That is, like, all that's on there that I've seen. So I don't know if people are actually using Vero.
The porn industry is the early adopter industry. They are the cutting edge of technology. When the sex bots finally take over, they will be the most advanced beings on Earth.
Is the porn industry... I feel like the porn industry is really dying super hard.
I mean, the homemade one isn't.
No, of course. Like, that... well, I mean, no, but that's what's killing it. Like...
But a new one will take its place.
Between, like, homemade porn that's just uploaded left, right, and centre, and... like, the ability to just capture stuff at the press of a button means that all these, like, websites that have, like, paid subscriptions are dying because, like, people just subscribe, watch, like, 100 videos and record them all and just upload them to a free porn website. And then all these, like, what kind of thing is triggered? And then suddenly, like, they have nothing. Somebody help. This tree is invulnerable? I don't know what's happening.
Sorry, I got it.
So, yeah, I don't know. Shroom.
Got it.
Do you have dynamite?
Yeah.
Where'd you get dynamite
from? Box. Pretty much every traditional website that has a paid subscription on it.
Oh, yeah, I guess. I mean, like, interestingly, you know, though.
Comedy magazines?
Like, gaming, I guess, is probably, like, the one thing that I feel like hasn't. What?
Oh, yeah.
Microtransactions.
I wouldn't say that's causing death.
No. I mean, they're dying.
Oh,
okay. Well, I want to see the next, because E3 is happening right now, isn't it? I want to see what the next round of games, especially what's that new one that's coming out that's like Destiny but not really.
Fake Destiny.
Oh, Anthem.
Yeah, I want to see if that has microtransactions in it, and if it does, the reaction to it.
I hate that. It's become a thing that a selling point for games is like, look, we
doesn't
don't
have
microtransactions or, you know, DLC
even
included. Like all these things that used to be normal are now selling points for games. Like,
yeah.
Well, there was a point where having no DLC was a selling point. Back in the horse armor days of Oblivion.
I think Red Dead sort of has that as well. Like you like prepay for shit, or you pre-order it and you get extra shit.
You mean season pass?
No, it's like a pre-order bonus. Did you see the pre-order bonuses for Red Dead today?
No.
They're like in-game buffs and shit. It's like,
but in a single player game. Like, I feel like that's way more acceptable than in a game like
Anthem. No, they're online buffs. That's what I'm trying to say. So.
Oh. For what? Does Red Dead have online? Is it going to have online?
Red Dead 1 had online.
Yeah, it did.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, you don't remember the fucking massive shootouts people had in that fucking Mexican castle?
I obviously never played it online. I played through the story, like, twice. So I obviously never played online. I don't know. I don't remember.
It's pretty good, the online, actually. I enjoyed it. It was like Breaking Point. Red Dead Online.
Okay.
It was cool. But,
yeah, I can see that.
Because there was a game a little while ago that had... Oh, fuck it. Was it COD? One of the most recent CODs that had, you got a bonus for pre-ordering it, and it was, like, it just gave you, like, a massive advantage. Like, it gave you extra health or more armor or something.
Well, I thought it was fucking Battlefront, the Star Wars one. I thought that was the big...
It might have been. It was a game that came out around that time.
Everyone just flipped the table with Battlefront. Reddit was going nuts, man.
Yeah. Well, Battlefront had a lot of issues. That was the problem. Like, it wasn't just that there was one thing. It was more the fact that there was a bunch of stuff. You could buy stuff to give yourself perks. It was Battlefront, now that I think about it, I think. You could, buy stuff to give yourself perks, which, made you way more powerful. But then, on top of that, to unlock a hero, you had to spend, 100 hours in the game or something. Like, it was really hard to unlock shit.
Yeah.
Without paying for it, I think.
You
don't
know how the major settlement's, right there.
Sorry?
You don't know how the major settlement's, right there.
What major settlement?
Oh, you'll see it.
Oh, there. Yeah, fuck it. Look, the idea is, we build something... We get attacked. We fight Helm's Deep to the last. I don't know. It's it's just, you've got to be so careful these days with pre-ordering and stuff. It's just, it's obscene. I have not pre-ordered a game I don't think I've pre-ordered a game since The Division. I fucking learnt my lesson so hard.
Yeah, I don't pre-order games anymore. I'll wait till the IGN review comes out and the Gamer Annex before you buy it, and then I buy it.
But the
even if the reviews are shit.
The pre-orders were really important when games were on discs and stuff, because obviously your local shop might be getting 50 copies. And obviously that's going to sell out, and then they might not get any more for a week. So you might miss out on that game for a week if you don't pre-order. Sure. Today, you can log into Steam, you can buy a game and have it in your inventory in 10 minutes if you got half decent internet. There's literally no reason apart from if they say, "Oh, pre-order to get this custom skin." Who gives a fuck? Why are people still pre-ordering? It's absurd. Oh, that's gonna fall into something. Feels bad.
Shoot! There was a fucking bird bath on that.
Oh, not two sticks and a log. Not two sticks and a log, Caesar! Where are we gonna find two sticks and a log? Fucking restart the game. I really don't understand people. You're not even supporting the developer. It's no different whether you pre-order it or you buy it on release. I don't know.
Can you stop destroying the shit? Jesus Christ.
I'm not even paying attention anymore. I'm just cutting stuff.
I know!
I don't know. Any good Kickstarters at the moment? You guys been backing anything on Kickstarter? Did you back the Crusader Kings board game?
No.
I watched a little bit of that.
It got funded in an hour.
Yeah. So I watched a demo of it at PDXCon. I think.
You went to PDXCon?
No, from PDXCon. Bayonetta devs. It was, it's on YouTube, I think. It looks okay. I enjoy Crusader Kings as a game that you can sit down, like, and just play for, like, 5 hours, like, have a night.
Well, you don't want to play with your dad.
Yeah, I can't see it being overly successful as a board game. I don't know. I'm sure it will be successful in terms of, like, people will play, but I can't see it being that playable, really. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong, but I'm probably not.
What a fuck statement. That was funny.
I recently... What have I backed recently? Phoenix Point I backed for, like, a little bit. The new release came out for that the other day. I haven't tried it yet. I'm a little bit disappointed already, I'm not going to lie. I feel like these engines, like the Unity engine, is really baking? It's really baking the games industry. I feel like people are just getting lazy. I mean, it's cool because you get a lot more games.
This is made in Unity.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, and this is a good example, I think. Like, it's an interesting concept. It's well executed. It's well designed. So you get a lot of games that are made in Unity that are just really fucking, like, lazily done. It's good because it makes gaming, like, game development a lot more accessible.
Yeah, there's a lot of first tries that people try to sell, which is, right? Like, my first game on Unity, and my last, was horrible. But it was free.
And that's the thing, but a free game, sure, who cares if it's bad? You get a free game, you play it for, like, SCP, for example, perfect example. It's a free game, it's terrible, but I still kind of like it because I didn't waste like $20 on it. It's the games that charge like, you know,
$40.
Yeah, $40, $20, and you play.
You think I'm joking?
Yeah. No, I know. Yeah, like I've bought some. And you play it for like 10 minutes and you're like, fuck, that's terrible. But you can't return it because you've played more than 30 minutes, whatever the fucking bullshit is.
I'll just say I gave PTSD.
Yeah, so now you've just given somebody $20 for essentially.
To jizz in your face.
Yeah, exactly. Speaking of getting jizz in your face, Sea of Thieves, the new DLC is coming out soon. I saw that posted on Twitter.
Do you hate that now or something?
I don't hate it, it's another example of, like, the Division. Like, it's just been way overhyped and it's just a terrible game. There was so much hype for it, and like it's a great game. It's well designed, it's well made, but it's just empty. Like they just need more content. Because like I played the closed beta, I played the open beta. It was exactly the same as the Division. I played the closed beta, I played the open beta, and by the time I finished the open beta, I was fucking done. I was like, okay, this is boring as hell. So I cancelled the pre-order. Well, on The Division, I cancelled the pre-order. I didn't pre-order Sea of Thieves. After the open beta, I was like, well, there's no way I'm getting this because I'm already bored with it after, like, 20 hours And the fact that you pretty much have to, like, it forces you to play with four people or by yourself or you just get raped.
So I'm getting raped.
Oh, no, I enjoy it. You've never tried it.
Isolate.
Do recommend. So what's the most you've ever spent on a game, do you reckon? Like, not including, like, DLC and stuff. I know you've spent a lot on, like, Paradox games in terms of, like, Crusader Kings and that. But, I don't know, what do you reckon, like, the most you've paid for, like, just a basic game is?
Back in the day of console games for $120.
That's true. Fuck, you know, that's a pretty good point, actually. Because I was going to say, so I bought... I'm not even going to say what game it is, but I paid a lot for a game when it came out to get, like, the early access and a few keys and stuff, because I thought it was going to be amazing. So I paid a lot for it. It was a terrible game. It's now hugely successful with the addition of a new game mode. So try and work that one out.
Does it rhyme with Mortite?
Yeah, yeah. And yeah, so I was like, oh man, I feel really bad about that. That was a lot of money, but that's a pretty good point when you take into account that, like, fucking, like, GTA 5 on PlayStation 3 when it first came out was probably like, what, $120, if not 130 or something. I would have spent a lot on, like, PlayStation 3 games. A hell of a lot.
Hey, a spider.
That's not how you put food on the fire. Is this rotten?
Hope not, because I have no food. And you destroyed my own agent.
Also, I'm kind of annoyed because I had... So, have you seen Raft? It came out full release recently.
Yeah. People are like, oh, look, this is great, it's so great. I'm like, you idiots.
Why?
Good idea, but I really feel like valid, it's...
Caesar. It's... Speak your mind.
I really feel like right now it's... shallow.
Yeah. I mean, it's essentially like a boring Minecraft Skyblock, really, isn't it? Like...
I never played Skyblock.
Oh, what? You never played Skyblock?
Oh, no. Like, I played the fucking Battle Royale version where you were in the sky, but...
Yeah, so... that's not bad. So I played it very early. I played, like, the first release that they made of it. When, like, the characters didn't even have models. They were literally wireframe characters. And it was very basic. And even then, it was kind of okay. Shallow. I'm kind of intrigued. I lost my fucking key, is what I'm getting at, to play it, to get my, like, full copy. But I kind of want to give it a go, but I think it's, like, $20, isn't it? Don't know that I want to pay $20 for it. Are you attached to this tree that's glitching through the floor of this building?
I chopped it up. Oh god, what are you doing? He's gonna saw up the building next.
What? I can't hear you over the sound of my sawing in the building. Alright, do we have enough logs? I love the way you're just going to town just with the building. I'm just...
Well, yeah, it's like... Log boy. You know.
Log boy! Oh, we can't sleep. Fuck my life.
Yep, so go into the darkness and go get some logs.
No.
Okay then, well, I guess we're done here.
Make me. There's so many logs over here, by the way.
Wish I knew where they were.
Over here, where I am.
Yeah.
Follow me! I'm gonna make some more. I'm gonna make some more armor.
Also, please don't make more logs.
Why? You don't want more logs?
The game is shitting itself.
Get some logs! Now I'm gonna make some armor so I can disappear like I'm a fucking magician.
You ever wish you were a magician?
If there was some, if I could be some kind of special person.
Special person? I mean, you're not?
If I could be some kind of magical being, I don't think a magician is quite what I would go for.
You're saying magicians are fantasy creatures.
Well, I mean, what are you talking about, like, magician in the, like, I could do shitty magic tricks kind of thing? Or yes. Magician as in I fool people into thinking I can do shitty magic tricks? Like, do they actually have magic ability, or is it just sleight of hand?
There's a difference.
Yeah. I mean, the people you see out busking on Melbourne streets are fake magicians.
What?
What? Well, they're not actually magic, Caesar.
What the fuck?
Oh my god. What? Do you think they're actually pulling 100 meters of tissue paper out of their ass? No. It's a trick. Do you think Houdini actually... I don't know what Houdini was famous for. He escaped stuff, didn't he? Did Houdini ever saw himself in half?
I don't fucking know.
This doesn't work at all. Oh, also, fun fact. You can use that cart to transport bodies.
Oh, cool. Bring out your dead, then.
Bring out your dead.
Yeah, that's exactly how that went.
Have you watched... Have you watched any Walking Dead recently? Or at all?
No, I fucking gave up.
Where did you give up?
Negan?
Negan, yeah. I mean, the Negan thing's still going, isn't it? I don't know.
Probably. I don't particularly give a shit.
Yeah. I stopped watching at the end of... I don't know what season it was. Basically, like, Negan turned up and they were like, yeah, we're going to fight you because we have these people from the junkyard, and then the people from the junkyard
were
were with Negan and turned on him, and then, like, the
writers... Well, didn't see that one coming.
Like, the writers of the Rohirrim, the people of the kingdom, came in and they're like, Alexandra would not fall this day! And then they ran out and shot everybody. Alexa, shut the fuck up!
Alexa was there.
And I never went back after that season because I was like, okay, this is... I'm done. I'm fucking done. So I don't know. Negan's probably still alive. They really... I don't know. I love that series so much. But it's gone on too long.
Yeah, they needed what was called story progression to make it interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. Apparently, word on the street is who's the actor that plays the main guy?
Hell if I know.
I don't even know what he is. You know the guy I'm talking about, though.
Englishman.
Sure, yeah. Apparently, he hasn't been re-signed for the latest series.
They're going to replace him with a weirdo.
So either, yeah, he's going to get disfigured so horribly that anybody can play him, or he's going
to die. He's been disfigured so hard he's now black.
I mean, I'm not sure being black is a disfigurement, Caesar.
Come on. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah. I gotta admit, I kind of lost all hope in that series when, like, that whole bit where they sort of take over Alexandra, the zombies get in and there's, like, the fight, and then, like, what's his name? The leader shoots that girl's husband, and she's just like, okay, I'm in love with you now. And then I was really happy when Carl got shot, and I was like, yes! Thank fuck! His little whiny, cunty, snarky attitude is going to be silenced forever. Thank God. No, he survived! And it made him even worse, because now he just thinks he's awesome. I don't watch it anymore. I haven't watched it in, like, 2 years, but...
I'm pretty sure he's actually the main character.
Who, the kid?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, to a degree, yeah. But
I'm pretty sure the whole point of that thing, even pre-show, was like, it's a story of him growing up. Ugh.
Yeah, he's such a cunt, honestly. Fuck that kid. honestly, like, fuck me. I can't think of anything worse in, like, an apocalyptic situation where there's, like, zombies and stuff. I can't think of anything worse than a fucking smart-ass little kid that doesn't listen. You're like, don't go out, you'll get eaten. He's like, no, I'm gonna go out. Oh my god, you fucking little cunt, go die. Just let him go. Let him get eaten. He's just another mouth to feed. He's just a snarky little hat-wearing cockbag. Right, I'm done. I'm done ranting about children. I'm not, though. I'm never done ranting about children. I hate children so much. Ugh.
So, who's the father?
I started watching the new series of Westworld. No spoilers, because I know you
can watch. Yeah, we've already talked about this.
Did I tell you that I like watched the first one? I just, I don't know. It's, I feel like it's not the same, and I kind of lost interest.
I've heard the similar complaints, and I'm cautiously pessimistic.
I don't know. It depends. Like, it might be. It might be fine. I am going to watch like a few more and see if I want to keep watching it. But I feel like the whole interest with that show was that it was this world where interesting things could happen, and like a lot of the interest was seeing how, even though sure they're characters and it's pre-written, obviously it's not like watching reality TV, but it was interesting seeing how characters develop in terms of being in this world where, you know, essentially you could get away with anything. And like it being such a cool concept, and now like you've seen the last episode of the last
season. Yeah, Andy Hopkins just like, I'm gonna go now.
Yeah, and yeah, so I feel like it's lost a lot of that. I feel like it's lost a lot of the stuff that made the first season so interesting. Is about all I can say without spoiling it, anything. But yeah, you'll have to, I don't know, you'll have to tell me when you watch it. I just really need a new TV series to...
Well, as I said, I'm watching Stargate SG-1 at the moment, and it's fine.
I kind of want to, but at the same time, I'm... What the fuck is this wall? What is this? What is this? Explain yourself.
You're the carpenter, I'm just the fucking help.
That's why I'm triggered. Looks like you something Daryl would build.
Who the fuck is Daryl?
One of the guys I work with. Snarky comment, because I know he won't see it. Look.
Right? Starts watching streams on the internet.
Yeah.
Hey.
Feels bad. My boss occasionally drops into the stream and sees what I'm doing.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That's what you want, a good boss.
That's alright.
So you know he stops paying you, he just subscribes.
Oh man, I don't think I'd even be that mad.
That would he doesn't pay as much.
It would be a big subscription.
Well, you said it would have to be equal. He's like, yeah, you can make it off Twitch now, you're fine.
Yeah.
Still same hours, huh?
Just sets up like 40 fake accounts and subscribes with a $25 sub on all of them. Oh man, what a fucking... I should talk to him about this. This is a great plan. Guys, fucking genius. This will kickstart...
Sleep.
This will kickstart the Twitch career, and I'll keep...
Wait, what time is it?
It's gotta be like...
Don't even bother!
Yeah, it has to be nearly morning. I am dying due to, like, thirst and hunger, though.
Yeah, we need water and food, because we're gonna die.
Well, I'll have one lizard, you can have the other. Have you ever noticed that you cut the head off the lizard when you kill it, yet when you equip it in your hand, it still has a head?
What?
Yeah, that's right. Look at the lizard in your inventory.
No, just the way you said that. I know what you mean.
Look, alright. Fucking words, mate.
Despite being next to that hellish capital where they just kept attacking us, we haven't been attacked yet.
Yeah, I know. I'm kind of concerned. There's some berries here that you can eat, by the way. Except, you know, I just ate them all. So...
Well, thank you.
There's more here. Do you need food and water? Here, come and eat these. There's heaps.
I need water.
Yeah, here, eat these berries. Here.
Berries don't give you water,
do
they?
Yeah, they do. Bick.
Oh my god, they do.
Yeah.
Please don't.
What? Well, I mean, we need more logs, right?
I mean, yeah, but...
Then cut down the trees I shall.
Yeah, you cut down the ones that are closer.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't see
pull them on the house and immediately just...
Ugh. Well, instead of like a lunatic, actually cut them away from the house this time.
No! Tell me what! Oh.
The fuck did I just say?
I cut that one looking away from the house and it still fell that way. This one's doing the same thing. I had no control over that.
I don't believe you.
So, you've got 15 seconds to get into chat and look at what I'm doing.
Hey, Shift, you like survival games? Why don't you...
Do you have the forest? I feel like you have the
forest. Nah, I don't. What is it?
The forest.
It's just a little survival game.
It was actually completed there.
There's one called the Green Hell coming soon.
I mean, you say that it's actually completed. This game has been out since, like, 4 years ago.
No, it hit 1.0 is what I mean.
Yeah.
Okay, it got out of early access.
Oh, okay. Oh my god, that's falling straight back.
Will you fucking pay attention?
I am paying attention. I'm not looking at the house. It's still trying to fall. Look, it's fine. Don't panic. Stop panicking.
You can't make me. I'm adopted.
Well, I mean, no arguments here, but... what was the game you just saw?
Green Hell. It's like a pretty similar forest.
Green Hell. Green Hell.
It's not German, you Nazi.
How did that not destroy
the... What did you just break?
Oh, I may have broken something outside the house, I don't know. I'm trying to break that filthy fucking wall that you've built up there. Who's here? Oh, the neighbors have come to greet us. Hey, what's up?
They brought a fruit basket.
What you doing, boy? They brought a stick. No, I've got enough sticks. Thank you. I'm having a few
soaring intensifiers.
Having a few problems with standing on the logs. But the locals aren't that bad, I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, it's fine, as long as the day stay away from the kids.
It's fine, I've dealt with them. I did lose a lot of armor because I got stuck on a log and I couldn't fucking hit him, so I just stood there like a twat while he hit me like 5 times. I don't have any more armor.
Are you my daddy?
Yeah. How do you know?
Paternity test.
Makes
sense. I stole your semen in your sleep.
What? You milked me! You milked me in my sleep!
Well, you thought that was just a pleasant dream about
me. Yeah! It wasn't a wet dream at all! What else are you making up there? Are you making walls at any point, or are you thinking about
walls? Can you not see them?
No, I mean, like, palisade, like, defensive walls. Or are we gonna make, like, a trap wall?
Well, up to you, Jimmy. I'm not the sole architect here. Name's up Cody.
Trap walls are gonna... trap walls are gonna... He's still on my friends list. That's somebody that's on my friends list that I haven't played with for, like, 10 years. Don't even know if he's still alive, to be honest, maybe. Like, I have people on my friends list, like, remember, Jay? Like, Jay lags a lot?
Yeah, he killed me repeatedly and kept telling me it was accidental.
Yeah, I have his ex-girlfriend on my Steam list.
That's interesting.
She hasn't been online in, like, 500 days.
Windy.
So I nearly killed... We did D&D last night. I nearly killed... Well, I didn't nearly kill, because, like, fuck, I didn't do it. But we're doing the Tomb of Annihilation, which is, like, a pre-written module. And they nearly died.
Don't know what that means.
Total party kill.
Yeah.
They nearly all died. because they just have this obsession with going into a room and being like, let's touch everything! Like, there's... Like, they walked into a room. I clearly described there was, like, this large bronze shield inscription on it, like, the outer portal, like, statues and everything else, and, like, you know, like, there's clearly a riddle there, or, like, you know, a puzzle or something. And they just walk in, they're like, yeah, cool, let's open the sarcophagus. Instantly spawns, like, 20 skeletons, which proceeded to fuck them. To the point that, like, two of them were down, everybody else was on, like, 2 hit points.
Told you about my only ever D&D experience?
No, please share.
Well,
because I feel like you really enjoyed it.
Well,
I want to. You've arrived at the town of Arnholm. You see various wooden shacks around. There's a manor building in the center of the center of the town. It's like a stone building with like tile roof. Oh, I'd like to go and inspect the plumbing.
You're still hung up about that, aren't you?
I mean, what do you want to do? Do you want to, like, pull... Do you want to bang a hole in the wall to see where the pipes go? Or do you want to dig dig with a shovel? Yeah, I'm a little bit hung up. I'm a little bit upset that you're questioning my realism. No, by all means, tell me about it. Because, you know, I feel like... I kind of want to do, like, a Roll20 game and get, like... you and Burrow to play.
But I mean, I am interested, I guess, but I still get pissed off at shitty world building because it's too basically Tolkien-esque!
Yeah, at the same time, I don't because I know you're going to get shitty when there's, like, cliches. Tropes. I mean, the thing is, it's pretty hard to run a D&D campaign that isn't cliche-y and tropey. Like,
well, I don't mind cliche and tropes. I mean, you can do them well. You can do trope subversion, too. Do interesting things, new ideas.
I mean, the thing is, like, I don't know. You sort of have to remember that, like, in the end, like, yeah, sure, it's a free-form RPG game that you can do whatever you want, like, but in the end, it still does come down to, like, a set of mechanics, and, like...
Well, the mechanics got to do with world-building and fucking places and names and shit.
It's just, I don't know, I, like, you say about, so I mean, you said to me earlier, just for reference, why don't you make a D&D campaign set in a real place, like medieval Italy or whatever it might be. But the thing is, like, aside from the reasons I gave to you, which is like, obviously, I don't know enough about it to create that world or to run that world. But on top of that, you have to remember that it has to fit the mechanics of D&D, which is like sorcerers and warlocks and paladins and, like, you have to accommodate, like, the temples to the gods and, like...
Yeah, I don't see any problems, like...
So you'd be happy with, like, a realistic medieval Italy where elven sorcerers are running around... Casting.
You don't have to have elven sorcerers, you can have fucking...
No, but you do. That's the thing,
what is
though.
It? Stop for a second! You can easily base, like, fucking Dark Souls' way of dealing with fucking miracles. Just have, like, actual magic, just with faith. Like, have a priest that can cast healing things.
Yeah, but, so in that sense, you're not really talking about doing a D&D campaign. You're talking about doing, like, a custom RPG adventure.
Does it really matter?
Well, I mean, no, I mean...
I know these campaigns exist. I just don't understand what the fucking...
Well, the problem's the preparation. Like, on top of running the world, like, building and running the world, you would also have to plan, set out, like, what sort of a system you're going to use in terms of, like, classes and races. Well, I mean, I'm assuming they'll just be human... for races,
well,
if it's going to be...
Yeah, so you can have, like, different cultures, like German, Norman...
Yeah, exactly. Frank. But that's all stuff that you would have to... Like, it would take weeks to write that out if... like, you know, it's... It would take a lot of work, is all I'm saying. Like, it's possible, sure. But it would take so much work that it's just insane. Like, it takes literally months of... sessions to plan out an RPG, but half of it's already written for you because it's tropey. Like, let alone trying to do something like that. You know, certainly doable. Just,
yeah. Can't be asked.
Well, it's not that I can't be asked. If I was being paid by somebody to do it, I would happily do it. But the fact that I have to go to work and work my ass off for like 8 hours a day so that I could afford to live, so that I could come home and fucking...
I get it. You don't want to do D&D because you like to eat.
Yes, because I'm some sort of mortal flesh being that needs to consume food to survive. Yes. Yeah. No, look, if I could spare the time to do it, I would. But I don't say you could be doing it right now. I would leap through the Ethernet cable and punch you in the neck.
Why would I say that? I could be writing right now, but here I am, wasting time on the forest.
Exactly. Fucking exactly. I could be writing the D&D campaign, yeah, I'm not. That's what, like, I said to the D&D guys last night, I'm like, oh, I'm trying to write it, but I don't have much time. Like, and they fucking laughed, and they're like, what do you mean you don't get much time? Fuck it, I saw you were awake at like 4 a.m. the other day on Snapchat. I'm like, yeah, I posted a picture on Snapchat of me, like, on my screen when I was writing the campaign, and I'm like, fuck, it's 4 a.m. And they're like, what do you mean you don't get any time? It's not like I stay up to 4 a.m. every morning. I got into the zone with fucking writing, and before I knew it, it was 4 a.m. I had to get up at 6 and go to work. Like, that's not something I want to do. And they're like, oh, you get plenty of time, you're up to 4 a.m. I'm like, no, I'll do that every night and enjoy my 2 hours sleep before I go to work. Good times. Fucking a-holes. But yeah. Anyway, in other, like, continue. What was your one D&D?
Oh, Jesus Christ, what have we got? TAFE. It wasn't TAFE, yes. Alright, so is it TAFE? The game program was like, I play some D&D, I'm like, fine. And first thing we do is like, we get to this point, and someone told me, oh, you have this spell where you can teleport people into other dimensions. I'm like, what can I do there? It's like,
door.
Oh, you just teleport people. Like, okay, how can I use this? Like, you just teleport, like, okay. First thing we do is like, everyone, grab my hand! And it's just, we're in combat. And like, everyone's like, okay. And I was like, well, here we are. And I just left everyone there.
Oh, like the pocket dimension thing. Yeah. Yeah. Good times.
And that's my D&D story.
That's... Yeah, see, and that's why I feel like we'd have to do a very... Like, so I'm trying to run, like... For the other guys, I'm
running... You have to put chains on me.
No, for the other guys, I'm running, like, a fairly strict campaign. Like, we have fun, but in terms of... like keeping it moving and stuff, we stick fairly well to the mechanics of the game. I feel like if we were going to run a campaign between like you and Burrow and whoever else, it would have to be a very loosely based game. Because I can just see like something like that will happen and then you leave them there and then die. So like,
you're a game master, you can contrive some bullshit.
Yeah, exactly. Like, in strict, you know, like, sort of mechanics, they would be stuck there.
The Valkyrie of Thyrin comes up and then gives you a blowjob, yes.
Yeah, so, you know, it would have to be a very loose game, I think, to accommodate you guys. But, yeah, I don't know. What about, like, some Edge of the Empire? Would you be interested in some Star Wars?
What? I think I know enough about Star Wars to really...
I mean, you don't really need to. I mean, do you know enough about D&D to play D&D?
Fuck no.
No, well, there you go. You probably know more about Star Wars than you do about D&D.
Yeah, but one's a system, the other one's a world.
Yeah. I don't know, I really want to try some Edge of the Empire, but I don't know who to play it with, because... All of my, like, IRL friends do not know the slightest thing about about Star Wars. Like I said to Tim the other day about Jar Jar, and he went, Roger, Roger. And I was like, yep, you're not playing.
That's a Jar Jar. That's so, what Jar Jar does.
I think it was Jar Jar. I said something.
It wasn't something obscure like fucking, I don't know, who's the Rube Susecure? Nuke Gunray.
No, like, I could have said, like, Stormtrooper, and he went Roger, Roger, or something. Like, it was something, like, really fucking, really dumb.
What an idiot!
But yeah.
fuck.
So I bought, basically, because Roll20 is like an online source, right? So it's like a website that you can go to and like create maps and run a game on and that. It looks like they've recreated a Steam version, so there's actually like a Steam app that you can run. And it's like Roll20, you create the maps, people join, and you play through Steam, essentially. So I was looking at that. It seems okay, but those things take a long time to learn. But the interesting thing with that is there's a lot of, like, Edge of the Empire resources there, so there's, like, ship components and stuff like that. But, yeah, so, I don't know. That's something we could look at down the track. I'm really enjoying D&D at the moment. I don't want to, like, oversaturate myself with it, though.
Oh, you're going to.
Well, I'm not, because, like, it's kind of good.
You're the dungeon master. You will.
It's kind of good because, like, the guys that do the Wednesday night one, we can literally only play once a week, because that Wednesday nights is the only time that all of us are available. And on one hand, it sucks because we only get to play once a week. But on the other hand, it's really good because we only get to play once a week. Because I feel like if you start playing more than that, like you can get maybe not bored of it, but like, yeah, you can literally just oversaturate yourself with it.
Get moist.
Yeah. Which one of them messaged me just before and said, "Oh, we haven't got XP for the last 2 weeks."
Yeah, fuck.
Well, no, you have. It's just irrelevant because you're like 30,000 XP away from your level up. So who cares? I have it written down. All right. Stop messaging me at like 7 o'clock at night.
Why not?
Well, I mean, it's like work. I don't want to... Like... So the guy I work for is really good. Like, he, fucking great guy to work for. Great guy to work for. Great guy in general. But it's funny because he's worked out that after 4 o'clock, he just doesn't even try and contact me. Because, like, if it's not work hours, I do not want to hear from people at work. All right? I don't care. I'm done. And it's sort of the same goes for, like, D&D people. Sure, I'll think about the campaign because I have to plan and I have to work stuff out. But don't message me because I'll fucking hatchet you.
Don't even talk to me.
Yeah. I'm a very antisocial person.
Yeah, I noticed.
How
the fuck?
What are you trying to build, you whore?
A stair.
Oh, I'm out of arrows. Piss in a blanket.
Don't steal my lines.
Fuck you.
Throw up some logs, would you?
Come to me, bird. Look at him. He's like, throw me some logs, like as if I'm his fucking lackey. You fucking...
Give me some logs. Good job. Damn it.
Stepped into that one. That one bounced off the house and hit you. I'm out of rocks.
Oh, I got one. Here, catch this.
Oh, God. Here we go. Wait, can I actually pick this up? Oh. Ow.
Yeah, good times.
It really doesn't do much to players, actually. That took off like 2 pieces
of armor. Yeah, on normal.
Yeah, on normal, yeah. That, I cannot stand that crooked wall on the house. Why is it like that?
I don't know. Probably because I deleted the floor underneath it, maybe.
Yeah, that's what it'll be. It's absolutely what it'll be. I just have like no equipment whatsoever. Good grief. Oh. Whoa. Having a bit of trouble picking up that log. Where? Oh, I just found more fuel for the chainsaw right here.
I know, it respawns too.
Guess what that means?
Infinite chainsaws.
More chainsawing. Mate, more chainsawing.
Did you do all this on one fucking barrel?
No, I did all this on like six barrels.
Alright.
I ran out of fuel. I was carrying as much as I could and I ran out. So, you know. Oh, hey guys.
What's up? You angered the wilderman.
Oh. The problem is they like stun lock you. Feels bad. Oh, I see a protector case. Flares. And a small rock to throw at you. Boobies, get out of here. Can I cut down your tree?
By the way, we're out of food, like, entirely.
Well, I mean, there's fucking rabbits and stuff, you know?
I don't have any arrows.
Neither do I.
Yeah, they have to throw rocks at rabbits. In the dark.
Why don't we make a few rabbit traps and breed them?
Let's make well, a why rabbit don't
farm.
Ya?
Let's make a rabbit farm. Rabbit farm. Rabbit farm. Come on, shift. Rabbit farm. Rabbit farm. Rabbit farm. No?
You're not playing this game, you fucking tool.
You don't have to be playing the game to be on board with the rabbit farm idea.
They take ages to breed.
Rabbit farms are fucking brilliant, I mean. Get on board with the rabbit farm.
I'm legit gonna die.
Why are you going to die?
Hunger.
You've got small stones, right? Or did you throw them all at me?
What am I going to use small stones for?
Throw it at a fucking bird or something and then eat it. Eat it like the fucking animal that you are.
Yeah. There's no need to call me names.
There's so many birds just like fluttering around you.
Oh, I got a lizard carcass. Cool. Where did I get that from?
Picked up a log and it turned off my chainsaw.
Do you wish to sleep with me?
Let me finish this trap real quick in case we catch something.
Where'd that bird go? Ready?
Hang on. I didn't realize you had like a stick holder there. Here I am walking around in the dark trying to find sticks.
Well, I built this like nice little fucking enclave and you're like just dropping trees on it now. It's mostly gone.
Yeah! That's what I do back. All night. Petrol fumes just blowing into the tent.
Yeah, get carbon monoxide poisoning. Oh, yeah. The trees are growing back.
Yay! See if I can kill a bird with that. There is cannibal to eat here, by the way. There's like a few dead bodies. Not that bird. Desperate. Loving it, mate.
Yes, you're just walking after a bird slowly, holding a chainsaw around each chest, arms straight, just going. This bird just like lazily flapping away.
Fly into my blade! I need to make a. How do you make a stick bag?
Carefully.
Stick bag. Good. Two ropes and some cloth.
I like how I just kill a bird and another one comes and lands on my hand.
One rabbit skin. Oh, true. Cool. I got a stick bag. I really need this bird. No, don't fly away. Don't.
My feather.
I only needed one to make some more arrows, so we're Gucci. We're Gucci now. Now we're cooking with wood.
I'm cooking with money.
I made some bone arrows because I'm fucking nuts. Some bone arrows, get it? If you say it fast enough, it sounds like you're saying I made some bow and arrows. Funny. what the fuck? There's blueberries over here. Why aren't you eating the berries?
It was night time.
Be a little berry bitch. Fucking blueberries everywhere over here. Bam, I've just filled my hunger and thirst.
Not today, Satan.
What's that from?
I don't know.
What? That berry bush just saved that rabbit's life. I'm fucking super triggered. Plants are protecting the herbivores. What?
Make it sound like it's like a fucking crime against nature.
It is! What the fuck? They're not allowed to rise up against us. We are the dominant
species. We are the dominant species!
We are the humans of Earth are the dominant species. Worship us! I sound like, sounds like something fucking Loki would say.
God damn it.
Have you watched Infinity War yet?
How many times? I just don't care about
watch it!
We've gone through this. I just...
Have you watched the Solo movie?
No. Why would I watch the Solo movie?
I don't know. I haven't watched it either yet. I just don't...
I knew it was going to be a trash fire, and lo and behold, it's a trash fire. It's a
trash fire, yeah. Apparently it's not that bad. Like, as a movie... It's apparently pretty good. I haven't watched it. This is just secondhand opinion.
Yeah, secondhand semen, right? Yeah.
But yeah, apparently as a movie, it's pretty good. As a Star Wars movie, it's trash. Because it's just like... Like, you know, there's a scene in... what's the fucking... The Last Jedi. Is it The Last Jedi? I think so.
Probably.
Where Han... is like, oh, can I use that to Chewie? And he like takes his bowcaster and shoots it. And he's like, wow, this thing's amazing.
Let me guess, he does it in the prequel.
Well, no, the thing is, I mean, Han's what, like 30-ish? Oh, well, no, sorry. In The Last Jedi, he's like what, 60 or like 50, 60, something like that.
I thought it was 500 years old.
So, I mean, him and Chewie have been travelling together for, like, 30 years. Do you not think, in that time, Han would have used the bowcaster? In 30 years of doing dumb shit, he probably used that bowcaster at some point. But,
and so, you get so upset at me for pointing out your plumbing.
Huh? So...
What?
No, so he... This is going somewhere, though, right? So... So in this stupid new movie, he's like, oh, can I use that? And he uses it, and he's like, wow, this is amazing. You know, like, I got to get one of these, or whatever he fucking says. So, of course, in the Solo movie, just to make that line, like, sorry, I'm speculating. I'm sort of speculating. I'm using this as an example, and it may not even be a proper example. I'm just realizing as I say this. But basically...
Fucking spit it out!
It's a lot of, like, fan service. So they're just, like... They're making a lot of stuff... Like... I can't think of the wording to say what I want to say.
references.
They use the movie to just excuse a lot of dumb shit, is what I'm trying to say. Like, so an example of that, which I don't know is actually in the movie. This is just like a joke that was going around. But like, you know, like you could be like, oh, that, what a stupid looking weapon. I'm never going to use that. And then, you know, that excuses him using it for the first time in 40 years fucking in the movie sort of thing. Which again, might not be in the movie. It was just an example. But apparently there's a lot of that. There's a lot of like just bullshit explaining who Han Solo is and how, you know, how he learnt to shoot first kind of stuff. Because apparently people need that explanation because they haven't, you know, people can't work out characters for themselves anymore. I guess they need a fucking a backstory movie to clarify who a character is or something. I don't know. Fucking, of all the things you can make a Star Wars movie about, fucking Han Solo. Shoot me in the dick. Shoot me in the dick and tell me I deserve it. Do it!
But he was the main character, though.
I mean, he wasn't.
Really?
Yeah. Unfortunately, the main character was a whiny little bitch who wanted to be a Jedi. And who just, like, fucking, after receiving nobody's training, decided to call himself a Jedi Knight. And somehow, after hiding on a rock... I mean, sure, he had the text, but I mean, nobody trained him, did he? Did they? Like, I feel
Force
like...
Force ghosts.
Yeah, like, I mean...
But that's the whole reason they did that, was to train people.
What? The whole reason of what?
Like, the whole reason they like became Force ghosts was to train the next generation.
Oh, I don't know. So, Qui-Gon Jinn worked out how to do the Force ghost thing.
I know, I know. Yeah.
And yeah, that's what I'm getting at. Like, maybe he was trained by, like, Yoda and Obi-Wan or whoever.
I'm pretty sure it's explicitly stated that he was. They just continued it as in ghost form.
Where was it? Because that's
I don't fucking know.
That's what I'm getting at. Like, I don't know that it is, anyway. Maybe it is, but I'm not aware of it. Like, I feel like he just went from a bitchy little farm boy... to calling himself a Jedi Master under the guidance of just no one, ever. But maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. Because... I don't know.
Yeah, so saying Luke Skywalker is the equivalent of a HEMA practitioner that learns everything off YouTube.
Yeah! He's basically me in all forms of life.
That's why you hate him.
I have no proper training in any field... I just watch a lot of YouTube videos. Which, I mean, to be fair,
I've always suspected.
Isn't entirely wrong. Like, I can paint, plaster, tile, and I've never been, like, a lot of stuff. Concrete, I can do a lot of plumbing and electrical. I've never been trained in any of these fields. Caesar.
What?
I don't know. I just fucking...
Do I shout my name?
I'm just... banging on. I was just looking at you. I don't know what to do with myself, really.
Well, I could use more logs. I could use help putting these logs onto the building.
I know, but I can't really...
Like, I'm getting the feeling that we're just going to abandon this, like, in 3 hours.
I thought the whole idea was of this was just to play it for this stream. I don't know.
Yeah. Fucking do something!
I am. I'm shooting birds as they come into land. This is now bird-free zone, bich. I'm also trying to jump from one side of this field to the other. How did I miss that bird? Where did that arrow go? I don't have many of them. There it is. Oh my god. There's water in the turtle. Water in the turtle! Get your turtle water while it lasts.
It's all good until you get a jackknife.
You ever been to the snow?
Yes, I live like an hour away from it.
Do you like it?
It's cold.
Do you ski or snowboard?
No, I explicitly don't. I'm quite uncoordinated, you see.
Yeah, I mean, so I'm not really. I was going to say
something. I mean, I can catch things really well, but no.
Yeah. I'm thinking about going this year, but I don't know that I can afford it, to be honest.
Jesus Christ.
What?
Get some money.
Well, I have money. The problem is, I work for myself, which means I have to pay tax, a ridiculous amount of tax. My ute is up for about $5,000, which is going to be due tomorrow.
What the fuck did you do to it?
Do you want to know about all the issues that my ute has? Because I was talking to my mechanic, like, 3 hours ago.
I don't really want to know each individual detail. Did you, like, crash into a tree? Is someone, like, just shattered it or something?
No, it's fine.
Why do you pay $5,000 for a car that works?
Because the problem is, it works, but it only just works. Basically, it had all these little, like, problems that basically I jury-rigged back together. Like, the fuel line exploded, I just taped that shit up. It had, like, some timing issues. I just, like, worked out what gear to put it in at what point to stop it from dropping a cylinder. Look, there was a lot of little issues, so I sent it in to the mechanic because basically, we do a lot of jobs where I have to drive, like, I don't know, 1.5, 2 hours away. And I don't want to break down and have to get it towed back to Ballarat, because that will cost me, like, $1,000 for literally nothing. So I was like, all right, fine, I'll send it in. I'll see what needs to be done. I sent it in, and they're like, oh my god, what the fuck? Basically, it just had oil leaks everywhere. It had coolant leaks. The battery system was fucked. The fuel system was fucked. The air intake was fucked. One of the intake manifolds had shattered. What else was wrong? The clutch was gone. It needs a new clutch. One of the valves in like the lower housing of the engine was gone. There was just like a million little things. And basically, by the time you pull the engine apart, so it's my ute has literally been in the shop for 6-7 days now. Well, it'll be 7 days tomorrow. So, like, you know, by the time you add up, like, labor for a mechanic for, like, 7 days, well, I mean, not quite, you know, obviously, but a few half days here and there or whatever, that's, like, the labor alone is, like, $1,000 more, probably, like, $1,500 just in labor. And then the parts, the clutch, I think a clutch is probably, like, $600, $700. So the glorious thing about my ute, though, is basically nothing in it is stock. It's all like aftermarket parts, which means so the clutch that was in it, which is now buggered, is a $2,500 clutch, which had to be replaced, which I've replaced it with a cheaper clutch. But you know, that was a thing. I got the brakes done not long ago because they were rooted. The brakes cost I don't know, it was like a few thousand just to get the fucking brakes done. So, you know, it's just, it's ongoing good times, essentially. Stop shooting at me, you little slut. Duped. Thanks for the arrow, whore. Clink chest.
Well, I'm out.
Whoops, that's not what I wanted to do at all. Yeah, so, you know, good times. Basically, he came back to me the other day and he's like, look, here's the stuff that has to be done before it leaves the shop. This is like the critical stuff that will prevent you from breaking down. And he said, this is going to cost about $3,000. He said, here's the stuff that I would like to do because it needs to be done. This is going to cost about $5,000. And then he said, if you wanted to go balls to the wall, you could probably drop about $6,000, $7,000 and get everything fixed. Slash replaced. So, you know, this is what people deal with. It's also tax time, which means I'm going to be up for about $10,000 in tax. So, you know, feels good. Feels good. Being self-employed. Let's cut down a tree if you want some timber.
I don't know, I'm just feeling kind of aimless.
Yeah, I know. I mean, if it makes you feel any better, the house you've built, I mean, looks pretty cool. There's no... How do you get onto the second level? There's no roof. There's no ceiling under the roof like we did last time, though, which is triggering
me slightly. You can go in there if I bothered to put a floor in there.
Go in where?
Below you.
Oh, because you can go in, like, through here.
Hmm.
Giggity 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 goo. I'm going to come on you. Yeah. Alright.
Well, this is a bust.
Any other throwables? I got a throwable here. Hmm. Oh, wait. You have some as well? This isn't fair. I think you're gonna kill me with rocks. Stop! How many more do you have? Ow! No!
Okay.
Oh my god, if that one had hit me, I would have died. Not even kidding. Does this actually blow up in your hand? I don't think so. Does it? Maybe it does. I don't know. Dynamite away! Alright, well... Have we had enough of the forest? Is that what's happening?
I don't know. Are we actually gonna do something, or are you just gonna... sort of... bumble around for a bit.
I was kind of just enjoying the bumbling, really, to be honest. Oh, you've got dynamite too. Yes.
Bet I can throw mine further than you. Hmm.
I don't even know where that went.
You blew up in the air.
Oh. Feels bad. I would... Are you fucking right? Look. Right. Kind of just enjoying blowing trees over. That's a nice toss. You do some nice tossing there, Caesar. You're fucking tossing your caber.
I don't know what I expected.
Either do I, really. It's just empty our inventory of any, like, throwables / consumables. Yeah. And then just fucking... Ow! You fucking slut!
Burn.
Headshot. That's right. Oh. Alright, cool. Let's wrap up, because it's 9 o'clock, and I need to go and have something to eat. And then touch myself a little bit before I stay up to 4 a.m. writing a campaign. He's going to down me again instantly. Oh, I completely fucking forgot.
Ah!
Yeah, that's right, you little bitch! Where are you? No one can stand against the might of the chainsaw. Oh.
I can.
Apparently you can. Alright.
Well, that's annoying.
I don't have my stream deck to, like... you know, do a thing. I'm just bouncing through random stuff because I don't know what button does what.
I'm beheading you.
Alright. Pan Derps, thank you for the host before, legend. Thank you for the follows, and thank you for watching. Tomorrow night we'll do something. We might try and... Where's Burrow? Is Burrow dead?
I know you are. Oh god, you are actually dead.
But is Burrow dead, though? That's the question.
I don't know. Right. Possibly?
Well, I don't know. We might try and do, like, a groupie thing. Otherwise, I don't know.
Group orgy! All the mates, I don't know. I'm tired.
How do you view? How do you view screenshots of a game? Oh, here we go.
Why do you want to view screenshots? Why did you take screenshots of that?
Of what?
What are you screenshotting?
I'm looking at my screenshots of Total War from that thing I was talking about earlier. Here's the chaos guys coming through the wall. It looks just like Helm's Deep. I'm not even kidding. Apart from the fact that, you know, they're still on, like, amazing tiled floor rather than, you know, like a muddy thing. I was playing as Dark Elves, not High Elves as well. But, yeah, it was a good time. Where's the... There was an ogre coming through somewhere. Where is he? This one? Oh, yeah, through the gate. This was the same battle. So first they came through the gate with the, like, armored trolls. And then they blew out the wall. Well, no, they blew out the wall first by the looks of it, because I can see it over there. But look at them. Oh, my God. There was two of them. No, three of them. Oh, man. Fucking Lord of the Rings battles over here. Good grief. I really want to play some more Total War. Says you should get Total War Warhammer. Get Total War Warhammer. Huh?
I get it. Fuck.
Don't get it, he says.
I just had a battle, right? And it was 50-50. It was a choke point. I held it and didn't move my troops at all. They attacked me and they fucking won for some reason. I don't understand how they did that.
You have 151 hours in it.
I know.
And you're like, don't buy it.
Kills me.
You nearly have as much time as I do. I've only got 158. Good grief. All right, we're done. Thanks. Bye.
We'll be right back.